This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video will provide an overview of creating the data entry forms in the REDCap project. When building a data form, it is important to determine the questions you need to ask before making the project. This will ensure you gather the information needed to conduct an outbreak investigation. For example, it is important to collect demographic data, symptoms, location information, and other case data. To gather all information needed for the investigation, important questions such as name, date of birth, or phone number should be included and marked as required. These questions will be the foundation for building the data form. To begin creating a data form, go to the online designer mode and click on the data collection instrument and begin adding fields. Click Add Field to create a new field. Select the field type from the drop-down menu at the top of the box. There are many different types of fields: text boxes, note boxes, calculated field, multiple choice, check boxes, yes, no, true and false, and more. For this example, we will use a text box. Front-facing survey questions are entered in the field label. Whatever is typed here will be seen on the survey. Variable names are entered on the right-hand side. The variable names will be used in logic, calculations, and data exports. Descriptive and succinct variable names are most desirable to aid statistical analysis and coding. The names may contain only letters, numbers, and underscores, but no spaces or special characters. They cannot start with a number. They must be unique and cannot be repeated within a database, even if they are placed on different forms. If a variable name is changed in one place, it must be changed within any corresponding calculations or branching logic. REDCap will automatically add an underscore if you include a space in the variable name. While you can choose to enable REDCap to auto-name the variables based on the field label, it is not best practice to use this feature. Enabling auto-naming would result in a variable named what underscore is underscore your underscore first underscore name. Auto-naming variables can cause problems, as REDCap will truncate any variable name over 26 characters. Validation can be used to ensure that data is entered using the required format for the field. Validation options are found below the variable name field. REDCap will not allow a user to input information that does not match the validation in the field. For example, an error will appear if an email is not entered using the standard email format, which includes an @ and a period in that order. Therefore, using field validation is an important part of ensuring data quality. REDCap allows users to validate fields in the following categories: date, date and time, email, integers, letters only, numbers, phone numbers, social security numbers, times, and zip codes. Choosing to make a field required will mark the field with an asterisk and will prompt anyone who skips that question to go back and answer it before completing the data form if left blank. It is important to note that the data will still save if somebody skips a required field. Designating a field as an identifier field is important for protecting information. Mark any field that contains protected health information, also called PHI, as an identifier. Users can limit who has access to the full data versus the de-identified data. Only people who absolutely need access to PHI should be allowed to view that information. When the field is saved, it will be visible on the data entry form and/or survey. At the top of each field, there are several icons that represent allowable actions. The pencil icon allows users to modify an existing field. Branching logic allows users to hide fields that are not applicable. For example, when asking if an affected person has symptoms and they do not, it would not be necessary to ask them what symptoms they are experiencing. Rather, the field will only be shown when the logic criteria have been met. To add branching logic, click on the green arrow. Conditions are defined through either the advanced branching logic syntax or by using the drag-and-drop logic builder. Both ways require users to apply logic that will complete the statement, "Show the field only if," with a condition that must be true for the field to appear. This helps shorten surveys and allows you to only ask relevant questions, which saves time and creates a cleaner data form. The next icon is the copy icon. Copying a field will create an identical field just below it. Since each variable needs to be unique, REDCap will automatically add an underscore and a number to the end of the copied variable name. To move a field, choose the button that shows paper with the crossed arrows or simply hover over the field at the top or bottom. When hovering over the field, a set of crossed arrows will appear. Drag and drop the field to move it within that instrument. You can also click on the paper with the crossed arrows icon, and REDCap will prompt you to choose where you want to move the field within the project. Holding either the Shift or Control key and clicking on multiple fields will allow users to copy, move, or delete multiple fields at once. Finally, clicking the red X icon will delete the field. There is no undo button when designing in draft mode, so keep that in mind when editing the project at this stage. This concludes the REDCap video on creating data entry forms. More information about enabling and distributing data entry forms as a survey will be presented in the next video.